CataractCoach.com. Complete cataract case, vertical phaco chop. We're going to show you the whole case from start to finish. There's a lot of fun in that. You know, a lot of people watch YouTube videos of people playing video games. It's actually fun to watch an expert play a video game. Those videos get millions of views. Well, we're playing our favorite video game. That's called cataract surgery. And so let me show you a traditional case here, a vertical chop. There we see the patient's nicely draped, eyelashes out of the way, lid margin sequestered, eyes in primary. We just filled the eye with viscoelastic. Time to make our main incision here. Let's zoom in a little bit, get the focus just where we like it. Here comes the fixation ring, and then using it to steel keratome in this case. And you'll see there's a very nice incision. Good tunnel length, I'll take it. That's a 2.4 millimeter wide incision. Here come our forceps. We're gonna create about a 5.5 millimeter capsular rexus. Poke in there with the forceps, start tearing that rexus. And the trick here is to really do a lot of pivoting. Watch this. The forceps are now tilted in that direction with the base on the right and the tips to the left. Now look, we flipped the pivot. The tips are going the other way and the base the other way as well. This whole pivoting technique is what allows us to have precision in the eye, but also to create that nice roundness to the capsular rexus. We're just pivoting the instrument. That's how it ends up so round. And there's the finished rexus looking good. Now for a vertical chop technique, you definitely want good hydrodissection. But we're gonna leave the nucleus in the bag. Don't prolapse it out of the bag. So there's a little bit of a fluid wave. We can get another wave, tap the center of our nucleus. There we go. Let's see if the lens rotates. And it rotates. That's all it takes. Ready to go. Let's recoat the endothelium with viscoelastic. Now comes the phaco probe port down. You can see there's the pink sleeve, so it's the 2.4 millimeter sleeve. Here comes the chopper. Place that inside the eye as well. Buzz down, dig in the chopper, and the two instruments come apart. We easily separate the two halves. Buzz in again. Look at the chopper placement now. We'll buzz into this piece here and we'll divide it up even more. So this first nuclear half came out of the bag so easily, we're just emulsifying it. After that first initial vertical chop, we pretty much just need to emulsify that piece. We've got one half the nucleus out, here's the other half, and there's more of a horizontal chop. So the vertical chop we did, here was the beginning, and that was to initially split the big nucleus into two hemi pieces. And that's the vertical chop. Vertical chop means both the phaco probe and the chopper are within the confines of the rexus. You don't have to go around to the lens equator. You put the phaco probe, aim it towards the optic nerve, dig in the chopper, aim it the same way, and just pull the two instruments apart. That propagates the chop from the anterior surface of the cataract to the posterior part of the cataract. And then you just fully separate it and it's completely propagated. So you can see in about 3 minutes from the start of the case, the whole nucleus is already out of the eye. So it becomes a very efficient procedure here. Lens cortex removal, using a circumferential manner to get that cleaned up quite nicely. And of course, I'm using a very experienced surgical tech. And that tech is loading up the lens for me. She does a fantastic job. And so I don't have to load the lenses. So clean up here, looking really good. A little bit of capsule polishing on the undersurface of the capsule rim as well. Really get this looking pretty. Now let's inflate our capsule bag with our cohesive viscoelastic. There you go, that looks great. And now let's get that eye well in the capsule bag. Here comes the lens. A little bit of a counter traction there. Get the tip in. This is a little bit of a tight fit because of small incision. And we'll deliver that lens. We're using the D cartridge, D like dog. That's a smaller tip cartridge able to go through the smaller incision. Putting the lens in the capsular bag, let's rotate it around, get those haptics to open up. And you can see that's a real nice overlap of the optic by that rexus, about a 5.5 millimeter rexus. Going behind the eye well, let's clean up all that viscoelastic. And we're just about done with this case. You can see we've made nice short work of it. So everything went beautifully here in this case. I hope you enjoy watching these complete cases. That's something new we've been doing here on Cataract Coach for about the past year or so. And watching the complete case from start to finish really does give younger surgeons an idea of what is possible and what they should set their sights on doing. and I have no doubt that many of you young surgeons in the future will become true masters of this craft. I love the surgery. I'm sure you do too. Thanks so much for watching.